And then Adam alayhi salam saluted me and welcomed me and said, "Oh my pure son, oh my pure prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you are welcome." After that, I asked Jibreel about that thing, why when he looked at right side, he laughed, and his left side, he wept. What happened? I said, "Ya Rasulullah, those people are the offspring of Adam alayhi salam. The people of right side, they are the people of the Jannah, the people of paradise. So when he saw the on his right hand, he laughed. The people of left side, they are the people of hell. So when he saw his offspring that side, so he wept." Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I was taken to the second heaven, where I met Isa alayhi salam and Yahya alayhi salam. Both of them greeted me briefly. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached the third heaven, where Yusuf alayhi salam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "That is the prophet who has been given half of the beauty, Yusuf alayhi salam." He greeted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached the fourth heaven, where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met Idris alayhi salam. Same thing happened. Then on the fifth heavens, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met Harun alayhi salam. On the sixth heaven, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Musa alayhi salam. But here, Musa alayhi salam started crying. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, when he saw, he started crying. And Musa alayhi salam said, "He is a young prophet who has more follower than me." So because of this, Musa alayhi salam cried. And the seventh heaven, the last one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "When I reached, so Jibreel alayhi salam introduced me to my father, Ibrahim alayhi salam. And there is a seventh heaven, there is a Baitul Ma'mur. I was taken to Baitul Ma'mur. So Baitul Ma'mur, where the angel visit and make tawaf daily, like we visit the Baitullah. That is the Kaaba for angels, the Baitul Ma'mur." And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there's a hadith, Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu ta'ala mentioned, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I passed by Musa alayhi salam. Ra'aytu Musa wa huwa qa'imu yusalli fi qabri." I saw Musa alayhi salam, he was praying in his qabr, in his grave. And then when I passed Musa alayhi salam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave the description of Musa alayhi salam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "A man, light brown complexion, tall, well built. That's a Musa alayhi salam." Then I saw Isa alayhi salam, a man of medium stature with red complexion, white and red complexion, and crisp hair. And then I was shown the Malik. The Malik, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Malik is the guardian of the gate of hellfire, the keeper of hellfire. Quran says, وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِي عَلِينَ رَبُّكُ قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِسُونَ. When the people of the hellfire, they said, "Oh, to tell Malik, the gatekeeper of hellfire, tell your Lord to make an end of us, because they are in Jahannam, so they want to come back." So what he said, وَنَادَوْ يَا مَالِكُ لِيَقْضِي عَلِينَ رَبُّكُ قَالَ إِنَّكُمْ مَاكِسُونَ. You shall stay there, you won't come out. So that is the Malik. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I saw the Dajjal, and I was shown a river." Actually, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned here, "I saw two rivers. One is Hawz-e Kawthar, The other is that lake, which is called in other narrations, the name of that lake is Rajab, which it says the milk of that, the water of that lake is white like milk and sweeter than honey. So this is the Hawz al-Kawthar which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted me on the day of Qiyamah. And then Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I was traveling. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I was traveling in paradise. So I saw a river about Hawz al-Kawthar Rasulullah sallam mentioning, whose banks were domes of pearls. And I asked Jibreel alayhi salam, what is that? And Jibreel alayhi salam replied, Ya Rasulullah, it is a Hawz al-Kawthar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, my Lord had given to me its soil, given to me this lake, and its soil has a fragrance of misk, kasturi. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam reached Masjid al-Aqsa, I forgot to tell you, and then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I led 2 rakat. So who was the follower? That time, all prophets. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated his Habib there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, he's the Sayyidul Mursaleen, the master of all prophets. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam led 2 rakat. And then, lastly, when we reach the Sidratul Muntaha, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, then this is the end of this universe, this world. Look, that is the limit of angels. From earth to sky, this is the end of the believers. From first heaven to Sidratul Muntaha, the end of angels, all angels. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, why are you leaving me? You should go with me. So, what? Jibreel alayhi salam said, this is my limit. I can't move even a little, otherwise my feather will be burned. You know, here one of the great scholars of his time, Sheikh Sadi Shirazi alayhi rahmat, he mentioned that Jibreel alayhi salam said, agar yak sire muhe bartar param faroge tajalla basozat param. If I move a little, my feather will be burned. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached to Hadratillah, the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told, look, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reached the divine of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so it shows, nobody on the earth like my Habib, and there's nobody like my Habib on the heavens. Because Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated his Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted a gift of 50 salat. And that, you know that story, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam descending, Musa alayhi salam met and asked about the gift. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. So Musa alayhi salam said, please go back and request your Lord to reduce, because your ummah won't pray 50 salat. Because I have this experience, I was granted only 2 salat, daily salat, they won't read. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went 9 times. So Imam Barzanji here mentioned a beautiful thing. So why Musa alayhi salam sending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again and again? Because he was looking the noor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of Rasulullah. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was granted 5 salat. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this, man jaa bil hasanati falahu ashru amthaliha. Anyone who did one good deed, he will get 10 rewards. So it's mean, if you pray 5 times daily salah, you will get 50 salah rewards. So this is the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the lastly, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala narrated, one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very happy and asked, "O Aisha, ask what you want." So Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala quickly went to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, her father, and told this story that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked what you want. And you know, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda said, "Okay, ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, tell us that only one thing, that conversation which you did with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Miraj." So Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When she said this thing, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Only Abu Bakr can ask this question." Allahu Akbar, radiallahu ta'ala anha. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, dear brother and sister, lastly, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Anyone who reconciles two brothers, who brings closer to brother and sister of Islam, he will get reward of Jannah." And then Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anha starting crying. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha asked, "Oh my father, why are you crying?" Abu Bakr Siddiq, look, he's granted Sahaba. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu mentioned, "How about those people who break the heart? If we get Jannah, if we join the heart, so how about the who break the heart?" May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease and goodness and make us from those who follow Quran and Sunnah.